that.
Not all, I'm going to give you a brief overview of the economic outlook as we start, that's already starting with this year's election budget process. We carefully follow the economy and what's happening nationally, especially locally, which underlies all of our assumptions for the budget. And there are continual contradictory reports, which I'm sure you're all familiar with as well. I just looked at the Bloomberg headlines yesterday, which I thought was a good snapshot. Two of them were positive and two negative. Factory output in the U.S. went up more than was anticipated last month, so that will lift the economy in 2010. Wholesale prices went up 2 days ago, and this morning the consumer prices went up, so that implies some growth. But if you look at the underlying, particularly for the consumer, it was all energy, and everything else is very restrained. So that makes nothing. But then home builder confidence fell dramatically due to lack of jobs and lack of credit. And Treasury Secretary Geithner was reporting and focusing on now that TARP money is being paid back, focusing on unemployment and the shrinking credit, thanks to offering credit, which is really coming on the economy. So very mixed message, no clear picture of economic direction nationally. Closer to home, we follow carefully what the state of Oregon projects, and the Oregon Office of Economic Analysis, OEA, has stated that they think the recession is, for Oregon, is either over or almost over. However, they are seeing what most national economists are concluding, which is that it unfortunately looks like we might have a jobless recovery. And what Oregon is projecting is a total amount of job decline for 2009 of over 5% in the state. So that gives a lower starting, even if we start growing in 10, it's a lower starting point in terms of number of people employed. All sectors decline, particularly construction and manufacturing, which were double digits, 14% decline in the number of jobs. And the state projection is that we'll start 2010 with mild job losses, followed by modest growth. But we're not going to see significant growth, like growth about 2% until 2011, and not return to our real pre-recession growth until 2013, is what the state economists are saying. Oregon unemployment numbers came out on Monday. The county numbers that I usually give you are lagging, so I don't have those yet, but the November unemployment for the state is pretty much the same, 11.1 down to 11.2. But the bad news underlying that is we're still losing jobs in the state. And the labor participation rate is declining, which means fewer people in the labor force, which is a good news for our payroll tax. So all of this, I give you all of this as background for the underlying assumptions for our budget as we start this process. Because there are many factors that determine what the end of the recession is, and theoretically, when we're going to start growing, but there's only one measure that really matters to us, and that is payroll, the size of payrolls in the Tri-County area. Because only when payrolls increase do we see our revenues increase. People, when more people are working, wages start going up, then our tax revenues start growing again. So that's 50-55% of our revenue. The other 20-25 second largest category is passenger revenues. It's represented in, and when the economy starts growing, our passenger revenues will go back to their highly quick rate of growth. So we are currently in the very early stages of the 2011 budget process. And because, unlike the federal government, our revenues and expenditures have to equal, we can't have a deficit budget. The assumptions about revenue growth and contraction are really critical, so that's why we spent so much time thinking about this. And it's important that we have realistic assumptions, because if we estimate too high growth too optimistically, then we have to make deeper cuts later in the year. On the other hand, if we're too pessimistic and we make cuts early on that aren't necessary, it adversely impacts our employees and our customers. So we really try to be very realistic and thoughtful about the process. So this is really just an overview. We'll be reporting back to you as the budget process continues, but the early indications are a good budget year.
that's a question